Where do I start? I think I will just go a bit back, and I'll request each of you, I don't know if you've watched Steve Jobs, he has an article he did a while back on YouTube called Connecting the Dots. And today my journey will be connecting my dots, because all of us have dots, from where you went to school, the family you are born, and if you're able to connect those dots, then that's part of your journey. So I'm a believer, and connecting my dots helps me see how God has brought me this far. So where do I start? Maybe after high school. My first choice was to do law. I'm still not very good in Kiswahili, so of course I didn't get to do law. And those days, if you can't get your first choice, you're either thrown to BA or BEd. So I landed in BEd, KU. And of course, you swear you will never teach. You know, this course, I am in the university, public. Yes, we'll give the degree, you know, to your parents. So yes, I did. I was in KU, I did business studies and secretarial studies. I know for the longest I would type so fast, and I'd never tell anyone I did secretarial studies in the university. You know, those ones of no, I did business. So I left the university, and my first job was in IT. That was my first touch with IT. I worked with Africa Online for about 3 years, and then thereon, we were retrenched. You know, you've just left campus, and you're retrenched, and you're wondering, okay. Thereafter, I worked with another IT company. I sold software. And after I sold software, I was working for an Asian. I was taught a lot. Asians are very crisp. In terms of when you type, after you put the full stop, you should leave two spaces after that and start with the capital letter. Yes, it was that detailed. So a lot of times I'll see a proposal and I'm like, there are mistakes. But it was my background. Thereafter, I left and I joined Britam. But at that point in time, they just started the asset management company. So I joined through the asset managers, and I was in sales. And over the time, I rose through the ranks. And much later, Britam was merging most of their common functions. So we were merged to the insurance. And I started selling insurance. I remember initially, it was like day and night, coming from asset management and insurance. I think we had this notion, I think we still do, that insurance is for old people. And, you know, it was different generation gaps and what have you. And in that season, that's the time I met Mr. Wahome. I remember one time we'd gone for a training for top performers, top performing managers. And I was in asset management, and we used to do a lot of financial advisory. So I thought I knew this thing, you know. I mean, you tell clients how to put their money, eh? So you think you know this thing. You budget, you have a few savings here and there. I mean, you're good. You think you're good. And as I sat there in Naivasha, and as you spoke, and you know how you just get those light bulb moments? And you're actually saying, I think I need this, you know. And for the longest, when I was in asset management, I would sell. I would sell those. Man, I used to sell. And I got an award every year. So I thought I was doing very well. But as we sat there, I remember I couldn't even tell the guy next to me that I need this, because they think you already know. You know, they think you're already good. But we talked, we were about three guys, and we were like, we have to join this class. Immediately, we have to join this class. I remember when I left, I was feeling desperate. You know how you're feeling a bit desperate? I was feeling so exposed. So I came on, I joined the class, and I remember that lesson of to buy or to build. You remember that when he showed us his house? And I was at that point in time where I didn't make the best employee. I was very restless. So after 2 years in a position, I either want to quit or to move to something else. And at least along the way in Britam, I was able to move through the motions, but at that point in time, I was really feeling I need to leave. And I was really feeling I need to leave, but had just gotten a promotion. In 2013, after Uhuru came on, I got the presidency. I just got this light bulb moment that Kenya will really change. in a way that if you want to start a business, you had better launch in those 5 years. And for me, I would always listen to Steve Jobs or anyone who's talking about anything business and how to go out. And I would read books. I remember I bought this, The Leader Without a Title. And I was desperate for some reason for like a year. Then I did 2014. In fact, I've just seen we were season 3. To buy, to build. And I remember speaking to Mr. Wahome and I'm wondering, do I buy? I'm very sure I will not build, dealing with contractors, and I'm a lady. And hey, I was like, no. But so I started looking for a house for a very long time, and I identified Kiambu Road. And I was like, okay, fine. If I move here, then that means I'll have to be driving with my son to Nairobi very early in the morning to drop him in school. Anyway, it was still an option. When was the GS summit? 2015. January 2015, early in the year, I had this dream, and it was so clear that I need to start a school. I need to start a kindergarten along Kiambu Road. It was so clear, and my partner is my mother, and I'm wondering, my mom, she's retired, but she's a retired teacher. So I'm like, I need her wisdom. And I share it with her. And needless to say, that was the last time I made a sale in Britam. That January. So I'm here, I'm still working. I have this coveted position and I am not delivering. And the stress, you know, corporate, the travel, it was so stressing, and I'm not meeting my numbers and everyone is wondering what's happening. After to buy and build, believe now I've seen I'll buy. And I started putting money aside. A local, Kilaguni, and they just fly. And I'm like, really? We thought we were doing well at Britam. So she gave me her experience, and she just gave me a contact of a business coach who I spoke to. And I think at that point in time, you think you know these things. So when I spoke to the coach, I was like, this Mzungu ideas, you know, they don't work in Africa. And I never talked to her again. But come December of 2015, I was like, I think I need help. So come January this year, I decide I need to go back to work. This school thing is not working, or my mother said it's not rocket science, because she felt that she's been in the education industry for so long, and she's like, it's a kindergarten. I mean, like, seriously. I don't understand why you'd have to do business plans and financials, and I mean, you know, coming from her age, you just start a school, you just go buy tables and chairs. I mean, it's not rocket science, is it? Go back to Britam, work as you run your school. But I think we know it different. Anyway, come January, I decide, let me go back to Britam and let me give it my best shot. I can't live at my worst. And now I'm going back to Britam as a salesperson, not as a manager. So it's different. The ball game is really different. And every Friday when we go to do our sales reports, my name is called out and I say, Neil. And I say, Neil, the whole of January, the whole of Feb. And I'm like, I can't do this. I just can't do this. Maybe I just need to resign. I had so much fear. I was so fearful. I had fear of failure. And I remember I decided to take a step of faith, and I wanted to import most of my stuff from China. And along the people I met who I didn't know assisted me, they helped me, showed me how to shop online, gave me the contacts, how to ship my stuff. So I remember I decided early in the beginning of the year just to go to the bank and make a deposit. Let me just buy a few tables and chairs, you know, step of faith. I need to do this. Britam, I've not sold for a whole year. They'll fire me, you know, I mean, like, that's the worst. So I go to the bank on a Saturday and I tell this guy I need to send some money to China. And he's like, you can't send today because CBK is closed. And I'm looking at him and I'm a bit confused and I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, yeah, you come on Monday. But he says, just give me 1 minute, and he goes and talks to a few ladies, his colleagues, and they're looking at me and I'm wondering what's wrong with these guys. But when I left, I remembered I've been in financial services for so long. I know you can't transact over the weekend. You know, I mean, really, you can't. CBK doesn't operate on Saturdays. I think blonde moments were very many. So I go back to the bank on Monday, and I go to the same guy. He'd promised to give me a good rate, and we transact. And there's a slot, what are you buying and all this. So I say, I'm purchasing furniture. And we have a conversation. And he tells me, you know, you're very different. You look very different from the person who came on Saturday. I'm like, really? Yeah. I'm like, why? On Saturday, you look like someone was pushing you to do this. You look like someone had held a gun on your head. I'm like, all right. But when I sat down, it just hit me that I was so fearful. And fear steals destinies, because hadn't I purchased those things, I would never have started the school. And it just hit me that fear makes a lot of people. I guess in heaven they'll show you what you are supposed to be and you'll be like, what? Because you are so fearful. And another lesson for me was that you really need to know the season you are in, because we are always in seasons. You need to know what season you are in. Needless to say, the time I left Britam, the time I stepped down, that month I would have earned the highest pay. It's coming from my-